Namaskar, hello and a very warm welcome viewers. You're watching a special presentation of Sunset TV on Gati Shakti. As India strides onwards to become a superpower, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has unveiled the Gati Shakti plan to lend speed, gati and power, shakti to achieve these targets. Over the next 25 minutes, we'll tell you all about this national master plan designed to bring in multimodal connectivity and decades of bureaucratic entanglements and working in silos that have hampered the infrastructure projects in India.
On the 75th Independence Day, the India growth story turned a new chapter when Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced the 100 lakh crore Gati Shakti National Plan from the ramparts of the Red Fort.
भारत आने वाले कुछ ही समय में प्रधानमंत्री गति शक्ति का नेशनल मास्टर प्लान उसको देश के सामने करोड़ों देशवासियों को सपना करने वाली एक बहुत बड़ी योजना लेकर के हम आपके सामने आने वाले हैं, उसको लॉन्च करने वाले हैं। 100 लाख करोड़ से भी अधिक की योजना लाखों नौजवानों के लिए रोजगार के नए अवसर लेकर के आने वाली है। गति शक्ति हमारे देश के लिए एक ऐसा नेशनल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर मास्टर प्लान होगा जो होलिस्टिक इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर की नींव रखेगा, हमारी इकोनॉमी को एक इंटीग्रेटेड और होलिस्टिक पाथवे देगा। अभी हम देखते हैं कि हमारे ट्रांसपोर्ट के साधनों में कोई तालमेल नहीं होता। गति शक्ति साइलोस को तोड़ेगी, भविष्य के रास्ते से हम इन सब रोड़ों को, जितनी कठिनाइयां हैं उनको हटाएगी। इससे सामान्य मानकी के लिए ट्रेवल टाइम में कमी आएगी और हमारी इंडस्ट्री की प्रोडक्टिविटी और भी बढ़ेगी। गति शक्ति हमारे लोकल मैन्युफैक्चरर्स को ग्लोबली कॉम्पिटिटिव करने में भी बहुत बड़ी मदद करेगी और इससे फ्यूचर इकोनॉमिक जोन्स के निर्माण की नई संभावनाएं भी विकसित होगी। अमृत काल के इस दशक में गति की शक्ति भारत के कायाकल्प का आधार बनेगी।
इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इज द नर्व सेंटर of economic activity. Over the years, nations that invested in infrastructure reaped massive economic returns. USA, post-war Japan, South Korea and China are prominent examples where infrastructure expansion was followed by rich socio-economic dividends. The Modi government's reforms underline this very basic principle. With a unified all-encompassing approach, they have sought to bind fragmented systems, be it the One Nation, One Market initiative, One Sun, One World, One Grid, or the One Nation, One Ration Card schemes. The Gati Shakti project is one more step towards breaking down silos in the government while bringing in departmental and ministerial synergies. India's infrastructure sector has been handicapped by complicated land acquisition policies, implementation delays and project overruns due to bureaucratic red tapism. Factors the Modi government has tried to tackle head-on to spur economic growth and achieve manufacturing competitiveness.
In a landmark event marking a milestone for India's infrastructural landscape, Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched the PM Gati Shakti National Master Plan. The plan is an important part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat initiative.
Infrastructure sector is a high policy priority. The Gati Shakti initiative adds a new dimension to project implementation in the sector. PM Gati Shakti is targeted at building next generation infrastructure to improve ease of living and ease of doing business.
Infrastructure se judi sarkari neetiyon mein planning se lekar execution tak ko ye national plan gati shakti dega. सरकार के प्रोजेक्ट्स तय समय सीमा के भीतर पूरे हो इसके लिए ये गतिशक्ति नेशनल प्लान सही जानकारी और सटीक मार्गदर्शन करेगा. ये भारत की वर्तमान और आने वाली पीढ़ियों को 21वीं सदी के भारत के निर्माण के लिए नई ऊर्जा देगा.
PM Gati Shakti is based on six pillars, starting with comprehensiveness. It will include all the existing and planned initiatives of various ministries and departments in one centralized portal. Each department will now have visibility of each other's activities, providing critical data while planning and execution of projects in a comprehensive manner. Prioritization. Different departments can prioritize their projects through cross-sectoral interactions. Optimization. The National Master Plan will assist ministries in planning projects after identifying critical gaps. While transporting goods, the plan will help select the optimum route in terms of time and cost. Synchronization. Gati Shakti will synchronize activities of departments and layers of governance in a holistic manner by ensuring coordination between them. Analytical. The plan will provide the entire data at one place with GIS-based spatial planning and analytical tools having 200 plus layers, enabling better visibility to the executing agency. Dynamic. All ministries and departments will be able to visualize, review and monitor the progress of cross-sectoral projects.
In order to achieve economies of scale, a nation must plan big and long-term. Infrastructure planning involves, at the very least, a 25-year commitment so that roads are not being perpetually constructed, bridges don't take years to complete, and big projects are not endlessly delayed. As Prime Minister Modi pointed out, one department constructs a good quality road. A few days later, another department digs it up to lay water pipelines. Such lack of coordination needs to end. Right away.
For a long time, India's infrastructure sector was plagued by inter-ministerial delays, multiple layers of stakeholders, and culture of working in silos. This confounded decision-making even as it inflated time and cost overruns and staggered the infrastructure growth. Data suggests that as many as 483 infrastructure projects, each worth 150 crore or more, were hit by cost overruns, totaling over 4.43 lakh crore rupees. Despite the debilitating impact of the COVID-19 pandemic, India's ambitious mission of achieving a $5 trillion economy is undeterred. It is only fitting then that the nation builds new supply side capacities. Not only will this set the wheels of growth in motion, but also use scarce resources in the most optimal manner. This makes the need for an umbrella framework paramount. Gati Shakti is aimed at facilitating planning, implementation and monitoring transport infrastructure projects to avoid delays, time savings leading to money savings that can be ploughed back into the social sector and others.
Hamare desh mein infrastructure ka vishay zyadatar राजनीतिक दलों की प्राथमिकता से दूर रहा है. यह उनके घोषणा पत्र में भी नजर नहीं आता है. अब तो यह स्थिति आ गई है कि कुछ राजनीतिक दल देश के लिए जरूरी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर के निर्माण पर आलोचना करने में गर्व करते हैं.
Gati Shakti is a great initiative by the government, which is going to provide the state of the art infrastructure to India to make it more and more competitive in the international market and in the domestic market as well. It will enhance the ease of doing business for the country and make the products more competitive, and with improved infrastructure and capacity building, I think risk management skills will become more prominent in India, and financial processes like the speedy debt resolution process will become more prominent and will help the country for the financial reforms going forward.
The National Master Plan will employ modern technology and the latest information technology tools for coordinated infrastructure planning. Satellite imagery will assist in monitoring, while digitization will ensure timely clearances and show up critical gaps.
The Gati Shakti Master Plan will use geo-mapping and real-time data in a centralized portal. It will allow departments and states to see major projects being planned, especially the ones with multi-sectoral and multi-regional reach. 16 central departments, including railways, roads and highways, petroleum and gas, power, telecom, shipping, aviation and others, will be a part of this initiative. The plan will leverage technology extensively. It will use spatial planning tools with ISRO imagery developed by Bhaskaracharya National Institute for Space Applications and Geoinformatics.
कि सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट के लिए क्वालिटी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर का निर्माण एक ऐसा रास्ता है जो अनेक आर्थिक गतिविधियों को जन्म देता है, बहुत बड़े पैमाने पर रोजगार का निर्माण करता है. हम किसी क्षेत्र में आवश्यक परिणाम नहीं प्राप्त कर सकते, वैसे ही बेहतर आधुनिक इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर के बिना हम चौतरफा विकास नहीं कर सकते.
गति शक्ति विल प्रोवाइड द पब्लिक एंड बिजनेस इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट कनेक्टिविटी प्रोजेक्ट्स, बिजनेस हब्स, इंडस्ट्रियल एरियाज एंड सराउंडिंग एनवायरनमेंट. फॉर द इंडस्ट्री, दिस डेटा अबाउट फैसिलिटीज एट अ पर्टिकुलर लोकेशन विल सेव मच टाइम एंड एफर्ट इन टेकिंग इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीजंस. अ प्लग एंड प्ले मॉडल फॉर इंडस्ट्रियल पार्क्स एज प्रॉमिस्ड through the scheme has been a long demand of the industry. It will ensure that approvals and clearances are pre-obtained for an enterprise to start functioning speedily. With the Prime Minister's focus on infrastructure, interventions are expected to be solution-oriented to bring projects on track.
India needs better connectivity where roads, rails and ports are interlinked symbiotically. When transportation costs decrease, products become globally competitive. Currently, logistics and supply chain costs account for 12 to 13% of the gross domestic product. Gati Shakti is expected to bring it down to 8%.
Instead of being planned separately in silos, projects will be designed and executed with a common vision. This will incorporate infrastructure schemes of various ministries and state governments like Bharatmala, Sagarmala, Inland Waterways, Dry or Land Ports and Udaan Scheme. Economic zones like textile, pharmaceutical clusters, defence and industrial corridors, electronic parks, fishing clusters, agri-zones can be used for better connectivity and make businesses more competitive. The National Master Plan fixes infrastructure targets up to 2024 and 25 for all ministries. The Road Transport and Highways Ministry has a target of building 2 lakh kilometers of national highways. It has to complete 5,590 kilometers of 4 or 6 lane national highways along coastal areas and connect all state capitals in Northeast with 4 lane or 2 lane national highways.
This is the time for the progress of our country. We need to understand that time is the most important capital. Appropriate decision with an appropriate time, with transparency, time-bound approach, corruption-free system and fast-track decision-making process is the most important thing for the make Indian economy a global economy and number one economy in the world. And here the Prime Minister's dream is to make Indian economy Atmanirbhar Bharat, making economy of $5 trillion. So we are marching towards that.
Railways have to handle 1,600 million tons of cargo by 2024-25, up from 1,210 million tons in 2020. The railway network needs to be decongested 51% with additional lines and two more freight corridors.
रेलवे की तरफ से इसका महत्वपूर्ण योगदान रहेगा. रेलवे रेलवे के साथ नेटवर्क फाइबर, इंटरनेट का जो ऑप्टिकल फाइबर है वो पूरा फाइबर नेटवर्क उसके साथ जाए. और सबसे बड़ी बात, रेलवे के जो गुड्स का कार्गो का ट्रैफिक है उसमें मल्टी मोडल कार्गो टर्मिनल कैसे बने, सबसे बड़ा कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन रेलवे की तरफ से रहेगा, मल्टी मोडल कार्गो टर्मिनल्स. तो गति शक्ति, पीएम गति शक्ति, मल्टी मोडल कार्गो टर्मिनल्स, इसकी अवधारणा बहुत जल्दी आपके सामने हम प्रस्तुत करेंगे. बेसिकली दीज विल बी टर्मिनल्स वेयर डिफरेंट मोड्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन विल बी इंटीग्रेटेड एट वन प्लेस.
इन सिविल एविएशन द टारगेट इज टू डबल द फुटप्रिंट विद 220 एयरपोर्ट्स, हेलीपोर्ट्स एंड वाटर एरोड्रॉम्स बाय 2025. This will entail building 109 more facilities. In shipping, the total cargo capacity to be handled at ports is targeted at 1,759 by 2024-25, up from 1,282 in 2020. The national plan intends to connect all states with a trunk natural gas pipeline network by 2027. This will mean doubling the gas pipeline network to 34,500 kilometers by 2024-25 by building a 17,000 kilometer long trunk pipeline.
In the previous 10 years dispensation led by the Congress government, the entire investment and expenditure on urban schemes was 1,57,000 crores. In the 7 years of the Modi government, one should actually say 6 years, because most of these programs started in June of 2015, the expenditure has accelerated and multiplied 7 times. It is 11,80,000 crores now, and it is ongoing. Recently, 2 more schemes have been introduced whose combined expenditure in 5 years will be over 4,50,000 crores. Gati Shakti proceeds one step further.
The master plan aims to achieve 1.7 lakh crore turnover in defense production, along with 38 electronics manufacturing and 109 pharma clusters by 2024-25.
The Gati Shakti plan seeks to transform attitudes. According to Prime Minister, the new slogan is Will for Progress, Wealth for Progress, Work for Progress, Plan for Progress, and Preference for Progress.
Apart from promoting manufacturing competitiveness, the plan is expected to boost job creation, especially in the rural areas, at a time when the country is recovering from the COVID-19 pandemic. This will have a cascading positive impact, increasing the standard of living of people while speeding up progress and growth. The master plan promises to engage all stakeholders while ensuring last mile connectivity. The implementation framework includes the empowered group of secretaries, network planning group and technical support unit with the necessary competence. The cabinet secretary will head the empowered group of secretaries and will have secretaries of 18 ministries as members and as the head of logistics division as member convener.
Spending on infrastructure is heavily dependent on governments, but there is only so much that governments can do, especially during a pandemic like COVID-19 that demands unprecedented focus on health and social needs. Even as novel methods are needed to replace conventional funding to create infrastructure.
The Gati Shakti initiative builds on the government's previous actions and policies to promote infrastructure. Public-private partnerships are redesigned, while new models like toll operate transfer and a hybrid annuity model are included. Access to finance has been opened up through innovative mechanisms like infrastructure and real estate investment trusts and development finance institutions. Over the course of its two regimes, the Modi government has shown that inter-ministerial cooperation can be seamless and well-oiled. Gati Shakti is another step in this direction for infrastructure development.
Clearly, the government's ability to take quick action is exhibited by the rollout of a master plan within less than 2 months after it was announced on August 15th. This effort itself underscores the seriousness of its intent to undertake reforms. Reforms that have made India a favored destination for investments. The Gati Shakti vision will also form the basis of PM's vision of Amrit Kaal, the 25-year period in the run-up to 100 years of India's independence, a period signifying the golden age for the country. Well, viewers, that's all I had for you in this edition. Thanks for watching and stay tuned to Sunset TV. Namaskar.